Hey everyone, it's Ben Hardy here, and in today's video, we're going to be talking about the used car market and the fact that we are reaching a breaking point and the car values are finally going to start going down. So I'm going to explain why this is happening, and then I'm going to get into what you should do to take advantage of the situation. And with all that being said, let's get into the video. Now, let me give you guys a quick summary as to why we're in this situation. COVID happened, auto manufacturing got shut down. Then once auto manufacturing started back up, we had major supply issues. And so auto manufacturers couldn't build as many cars as they would like to. And then on top of that, demand initially increased for cars because people didn't want to take public transportation. But now it's pretty much leveled out where we have the same demand pre-COVID right now. But we still have that issue with supplies. And so we have just as many people wanting to buy cars, and we don't have as many cars to buy. And so the values on cars have skyrocketed, new and used as well. Again, this video is mostly about used, but that's pretty much what's happened. And that's kind of our quick summary. Now, fast forward to today. And obviously we're still having these supply issues like I just stated, but there is a big shift, and that shift is away from people buying used cars. What was happening is, right, we still had the same amount of demand, supply was super low, and so people were just buying whatever was available on lots. But people have seen the price increases, and it's getting to the point where people just can't afford the cars, can't get loans on them. And on top of that, they just can't bring themselves to purchase a car for the amount of money they're having to shell out for them logically. And so they're just not doing it. And so it's actually causing used car values to start to slowly dip down. Now, it's not gonna happen as fast as we'd like, but here's basically what I'm actually physically seeing on dealer lots and kind of what's happening is people are only buying new cars right now. People are still buying used cars, but just not as much as they were prior, again, because of the overinflated values and because of what dealers are doing with new cars. So yes, there are quite a few dealers that are selling new cars for over MSRP, and it still kind of causes that issue where it makes the cars a lot less affordable. But there's still a lot of dealers that are selling new cars at MSRP, or they're giving slight discounts. The discounts obviously aren't as big as what they were prior to COVID, but there are still some discounts. And because of those discounts, it's making people go and want to just purchase new cars. And if they can't get the new car they want right now, then they're being patient and they're waiting and they're ordering. And because of that, they're not buying the used version of that car, and the used values are starting to go down. And if you go to pretty much any dealer lot right now, what you're gonna see is you're gonna see that they have no new cars, but they have used cars available. And if you look at the age on those used cars, they're pretty old at this point. And what I mean is those dealers have had those cars for quite some time, and it seems to be only increasing as time goes on. Because again, when someone looks, let's give my TRX as an example. If someone looks at a used TRX on a dealer lot, they're probably gonna see that it's priced at $20,000, $30,000, $40,000 over MSRP, depending on the exact package that that TRX comes with. And then they go, okay, that's pretty crazy. Let me go to a Ram dealer and see how much I can order one for. And then they go to the Ram dealer, and the Ram dealer goes, yeah, we'll sell it to you for MSRP. We'll let you order a 2022 at MSRP, and your order will come in. We don't know when, but you'll get one. And so then the person's gonna go, okay, I can get this truck right now, right, for $40,000 more, or I can wait, you know, maybe 6 months, maybe a year, maybe a year and a half, I'll still get the truck and I won't be paying that massive amount of markup. So I'm just gonna put the order in. And it really is what's happening nowadays. And order banks with dealerships are just absolutely massive. The Ford Bronco, obviously that's something that's been super hyped up, but it's a great example. The wait list is, I think, out to like 2023 at this point. It's something ridiculous, like the amount of people that have orders in for it, that are waiting for it. And I promise you, I mean, we've already seen it, right? There are some Broncos for sale on the market. And yeah, there'll be some people that'll buy those, but for the most part, people are just gonna wait until they can get their own order in, and auto manufacturers are kind of catching up on this, and so they're letting people do these super long order lists out to several years, which is pretty interesting. But that's pretty much the big shift. And because of that, again, used car values are starting to take a hit. And so within the last month, they haven't dropped a substantial amount, but they have started to slightly come down because dealer inventory is getting old. And then on top of that, stuff isn't being sold at auction as much of a price premium, pretty much, right? Because if dealerships go, oh, I'm gonna be sitting on this car for 60 days, 90 days, 120 days, whatever it is, and I'm not gonna sell it, I'm not gonna go and pay all the money to get that vehicle on my lot. Like, it just doesn't doesn't make logical sense. And so because of more people looking to buy new cars versus used cars, right, that's kind of starting to bring the values down. But on top of that, right, dealers are starting to see that as well. So they're not paying as much for these cars at auction. So the auction values are starting to come down. So it's kind of bringing everything down at this point. But it's not going to come crashing down. A lot of people think that this is going to just be like this crazy event where all the values are just going to drop drastically and they're going to be able to buy a used car for super cheap. That's not what's going to happen. What's going to happen is it's going to be a slow and steady decline because manufacturing is having a slow and steady increase as time goes on and as manufacturers get these microchips, right? For example, Ford mysteriously got a bunch of microchips. We still don't know how, right? But they mysteriously got a bunch of microchips, and so they were able to fulfill a bunch of orders, right? But now we're in this stage again where Ford is waiting for more microchips, so they're waiting to fulfill more orders, and that's pretty much every other auto manufacturer as well. And so it's going to be this thing where as soon as these supply issues kind of start to get cut off and the manufacturing starts to like slowly increase, then the values will start to slowly decrease. The only way that they would truly like really drop hard is if somehow every single auto manufacturer just got a surplus of these microchips, for example, and they could build as many cars as they needed to, then you'd see the values kind of dip, but it still wouldn't be that crazy fast because there's only so many vehicles they can produce at a given time. And so it'd look a little bit more exponential with a decrease, but it really wouldn't be as fast as what people would think. And so just kind of expect used car values over the next 6 months, year and a half to just kind of, you know, for most months, they're pretty much going to stay level, but it'll be kind of like a slow downward curve, but it'll be very slight. And so cars are still going to hold their values relatively well. Now, what should you do as a consumer in this situation? What I've been recommending all along. So if you have a car that you're looking to sell, get rid of it now before the values go down even further. And then if you're looking to buy a car, new is still the route to go. You just have to find the right dealership. And you obviously have to be very patient because you have to understand that you're probably not going to be able to get a car right away, or you can't be picky with options. You have to understand that the car that you're getting is not going to have all the options you have, especially if it's on the dealership's lot. It's kind of like if you want something now, you just got to take what they have at this point and live with it, right? And you just kind of have to have that mentality going into it. And then just understand you're gonna have to put a little bit more time into the whole shopping situation compared to before, right? Before, things were super competitive with dealerships because, well, we had more cars than customers, but now obviously there's more customers than cars. And so you might have to shop around a little bit more to find the dealership that's gonna give you the best deal on a car. And then on top of that, right, you're gonna have to shop around a little bit more just to find the car that you want. I've heard so many stories of people having to literally look all the way across the country just to find the vehicle they want because they refuse to not be super specific, right? They're like, you know, I gotta have this color, I've gotta have this configuration, I've gotta have these options, right? And it's like, well, you're gonna have to put quite a bit of work to find that vehicle and then to find that vehicle for the right deal. So just come into this again with the proper mentality that one, it's gonna be more time consuming than before. Two, you're probably going to have to, along with the time consuming part of it, you're gonna have to do a lot more looking at a lot more stores. And again, on the time consuming side of things, you're going to have to just be patient and wait, especially if you order a vehicle. What I've been telling people at this point, if you order a vehicle, right, yes, there is a potential that if you order a vehicle with a certain specification that the manufacturer might ship it out right away, right? They might have that specific vehicle built and they're just waiting for someone to attach their name to it. You might be that lucky person and get your vehicle in like 4 weeks. I've heard stories of that happening, but that shouldn't be your mentality going into it. What your mentality should be going into it is, okay, I'm gonna order this vehicle, and if they tell me it's gonna come in 6 months, I might not get it for a year. If they tell me it's not gonna be here for a year, I might not get it for like 2 years, right? So just kind of like, probably like double your time and just understand that's what's happening. I mean, that's what's happening with me right now with the Bronco. I ordered my Bronco and I have a first edition on order, and I expected it to be here already because I had a pretty early build date, and well, here we are a month later and it still isn't here. And so I just kind of understand at this point that it's gonna be a waiting game and I'm just gonna have to wait for that vehicle to come. And same thing with the new Raptor that I ordered as well. It's like, okay, it's probably supposed to come in during this time, but I've got to probably double my timeline, and that's when it'll eventually come in. And it's just how things are nowadays. But anyways, Hopefully this helped you out, and obviously I'll keep you guys updated with everything that's happening with the new car market and with the used car market as things kind of evolve. But anyways, if you're stopping for the first time, I really appreciate it if you'd subscribe, comment down below what you think, and I'll see all of you in that next video.